Hello, this video will take you through educational policy development analysis. Now, let us look at the system approach to policy development in education. A system can be defined as a component of entity. Now, let us look at the system framework using the input process output method. In every policy or in every system, there will always be an input, and there will be a process, then you have an output. Now, how would this work? Policy making input are those agitations. It could be protests, it could come in form of petition, it could come in form of militancy or demonstrations. These are areas that could, inputs that could come up. Now, let us quickly use, for example, if a while ago in Nigeria, where the labor were asking for more an increase in their wage. They were demanding the minimum wage should be increased from 18,000 to 30,000. You see, it was an agitation and it followed with protest. Right there, they were able to say through, and today the federal government have approved that 30,000 naira minimum wage. Now, it's a policy, but that policy came as agitation and protest. Again, policy can come, but policy can be made through a process, because there will always be a process for you to have that policy. Now let us take it bit by bit. We're looking at the input, we're looking at the agitation, we're looking at the support, we're looking at the protest, we're looking at the petition, looking at the individual or group, because these are inputs that can come in. Then when it comes to process, then it could be amplifier. You have the amplification, aggregation, analysis, synthesis, examination, and meetings. Because if you still look at using that same example of the minimum wage, you discover when the agitation came up, the demand came up, because they were demanding, they demanded, they used agitation. Then what followed up, they have to amplify, the amplification of it came up also through the media, because the media has to amplify it to say, oh, they are demanding for this. Then again, aggregation of it came up. They started analyzing, okay, will some of the states be able to pay, will some not be able to pay, and the rest of them. Then on the long run, you discover that there were meetings. Meetings were held, meeting upon meeting between the government part and the labor sector. So a lot of meetings were held, and that again transformed into policy output. And the policy output, when it was now approved, what went forth, they have to send it to the House of Assembly for approval, because it must go through legalization. If it is not legalized, then it cannot be a policy. It must go through legislature. If it is not, doesn't go through, it cannot be a policy. And again, that is why it can be, there can be sanctions when you violate it, because it has been legalized and it has gone through legislature. And again, there must be policy guidance. And the policy guidance have to be set on how it will be implemented, how to pay it, and how it will be released to the public. And once that has been done, the policy guidance will be released to the public. Because right now, yes, it's 30,000 minimum wage. They are going to walk it through so that at every level, each step, each level, we now know how much is going to be their salary. When that is worked out, it will be released to the public. And at the same time, you're going to have policy enactment and policy implementation. So you discover, still using that minimum wage example, it has gone through an aspect of the legislature. Now, it has not been released to the public to know how much we're going to have on the long run, per level, and so on. Now, let us look at the criteria for educational policy analysis. One of such criteria is the level of decision making. Now, you have to, before you can look at the policy analysis, you must take level, you must have been able to take a decision. We will be able to make a serious analysis to take a decision to say this is what should be after you have put what is in place in order. Now you have the expert and expertise involved, because you don't just go into policy analysis when those analyzing the policy are not having adequate knowledge required for what is in there. Because if you have to analyze a policy, the person must be knowledgeable in the area of policy that you want to analyze. Now, again, you look at the training involved. Now, what type of training will be required that will be able to drive the policy? Because if there are people that need to drive the policy and they are not trained, you don't have trained manpower, it could deter the success of that policy. Now you look at the type of policy that is involved, because policies will differ. it will not be the same. Like I just spoke about the minimum wage, that is one policy. But again, you have policy that banned importation of certain goods. That is policy too. So there are different variants of policy. And since there are different types of policy, now you need to study and know the type of policy that is involved that will guide on what needs to be done. Now, again, the authority involved in policy making, who are those authorities that are involved? Because it's very vital. You don't just pick anybody in policy making, but must be related and have been knowledgeable in that particular area where the policy needs to be carried out. Now, you look at the sources of policy. What are the various sources? Now, we've talked about where the policy is coming from, because you want to analyze the policy, you must know the source. And once you know the source, then it will give it an impetus for you to know what analysis that you're giving to it. Now, let us look at the policy analysis and educational development. When it comes to educational sector, what do we do? And in each sector, you must be able to analyze every policy that is in place, because the analysis of the policies will be able to give you a impetus to evaluate whether that policy is working or not and where it needs to be redesigned. Because if there is a need to redesign such policy, you restructure the policy. You wouldn't say because a policy is in place and it's sacrosanct, it must be there. No, because you have to rework the policy and ensure that the policy meets what it ought to meet.